Tizen has flexibility whenever you create your own applications, be it native or web. Welcome back to Samsung Developers. I'm Vincent, and I'll be giving an overview on the UI Builder ID tool on Tizen. The Tizen UI Builder is a graphical user interface tool, or GUI, that allows the creation of Tizen web UIs through drag and drop. It makes it easy for developers to create UIs. There are two main editors of the UI Builder, namely the Page Designer and the Animator. The components of each are the same except the Timeline View and Animator Editor, which are only used on the Animator. So let me introduce to you the components of the Page Designer Editor and then move on to Animator. The Page Designer is the editor generally used for laying out a single page on the Tizen Web UI. This shows the components making up the Page Designer Editor. The Page Designer in blue, Properties View in green, Resources View in purple, Pages View in red, and Data Binding View in yellow. The Page Designer is composed of the following: Palette, which contains the widgets for Tizen Advanced UI or TAU and HTML. Toolbar, contains the page navigation buttons, resolution, and zoom settings. And lastly, Design Area, is the visual structure of your application as you work with it. The Properties View displays the properties of the widgets selected in the Page Designer view. It is composed of three tabs. The first is the Attributes tab, which lets you edit the widget attributes. They are further categorized as Common and Widget Specification. Second is the Style tab, which allows editing of the CSS properties and creating CSS selectors. And third, the Event tab, which enables creating and binding custom actions with JavaScript functions. Next is the Resource pane. It has the following features: Resource Management, Resource Navigation, Resource Filter, Resource Import, and Easy Editing. The Pages view displays the thumbnail of every page in your project. You can reorder the pages by dragging them and also to create and delete page templates. The Outline view shows the hierarchical structure of the current page shown in the Page Designer view. The Data Binding view allows binding of data and UI during runtime, therefore changes are reflected instantaneously. It consists of Data Source Panel, which shows the hierarchical structure of all data sources. The Data Model Panel shows the data schema used to bind data to widgets. And Binding Information Panel, which shows the bindings you created between the UI widgets and the data. The End Screen view allows you to manage the content per screen. It shows the CSS layers and screen features, all under End Screen view, and also devices showing the supported device list. The Configuration Editor, however, is concerned with the settings of the UI Builder project, where the device, device info, and device feature is selected. The next editor is the Animator. It allows the application of CSS3 animations to web applications created by Tizen Web UI Builder. As mentioned earlier, it shares several views with the UI Builder, Page Designer Editor, but adds the Timeline view and Animator Editor as its additional components. The Timeline shows the keyframes of the widgets of the selected page. It allows the creation, editing, and deletion of animations on the Animator Editor. Moreover, it previews the animations while working on them. Highlighted in red is the toolbar component containing the tools related to adding, editing, preview, and use filter. That in yellow shows the outline component used to add and edit animation group and widgets. The timeline component in blue, showing the timeline to add, edit, delete, and preview animations on keyframes and keyframe units. The Animator Editor is a tab in the Page Designer which lets you work with animations and widgets visually. You can create a keyframe in the Timeline view and see the path you created for your widget. Summing up the video, I'll create screens for a sample application to show how the UI builder is used. Let's start by creating a new web project. Make sure to select the Tizen Web UI Builder. Here, I'll use a single page application and name it Web UI Sample. In the Page Designer, the template for a single page application was loaded. Again, here are the properties, resources, pages, and data binding views. In the Pages view, you can see a single thumbnail representing the screen on the Page Designer, elements of which can be found over here in the Outline view. Now, I'll create another page. In the Project Explorer, right-click on the project, select New, then Tizen Web UI Builder Page. Proceed till we're prompted to name the page. Then hit Finish. Back to the page's view, another thumbnail was added. From the palette, drag the button in place, then modify the text in the Properties view. Changes are applied instantaneously. Still in this view, go to the Event tab to specify the event and action this button will inherit. Next, I'm going to edit the header text by binding data. In the data binding view, right-click and set a new source and put in the value you want to take place. When you're back to the tab, create a new data model and link the source. Drag the data to page and don't expect the change just yet. We'll see it when we run the app. If you want to reflect the changes, you can simply edit them in the Properties tab, but keep in mind that binding data has its other uses. On the second page, we will use the animator and create keyframes to support animations. Move along the timeline to specify the animation length. Then back to the view to specify the direction. Now it's time to run the application on the emulator. As mentioned earlier, the header text on the first page has changed during runtime. Clicking the button takes us to the next page and also triggers the button animation. I hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. And also, don't forget to give a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to the Samsung Developers channel. Thanks for watching.